This is Neal, Dionne, live in Nashville on B93, sitting down with a good friend of the B93 listener family. Y'all know Jessica Harp, probably more for the time that you spent with the records and came and played for us, and that was great fun.
Oh, absolutely.
And we were talking off the air. I'm still having a hard time getting used to you not being a blonde.
Yes.
Because my media room, the first thing I see when I walk in is a picture of you there, smiling, blonde hair, and you've got Big and Rich on one side and Montgomery Gentry on the other side. So you're the first thing I see whenever I go into that room, and I'm still beautiful, but it's a shock to me.
Right. No, I mean, throughout the records, and even now, when the records comes up and someone isn't sure about the records, they're always like, so she's the blonde one? It's taken a little while for people to get used to the change, but honestly, my natural color is darker, and it's easier to take care of. It's really unattractive to be on the road for, 3 months straight and to have this, platinum hair and, 3-4 inch long dark roots. It's really not a good look. So this is a lot easier to take care of.
Speaking of change, now that you've relaunched as a solo, you make all of its decisions and you're a very prolific songwriter. So now you get to keep all of your stuff to yourself. That's kind of a good thing, right?
Yeah. You mean keep it to myself?
Musically, like if you write a song, you can keep it. You don't necessarily have to surrender it to another artist.
Right, right. Although I actually, I have a publishing deal with Sony, and I love writing for other people as well. So, not just for myself. I just love writing, so it's a release for me. Most of my songs are very autobiographical, and so this record was really special for me to make because it was really sort of pouring my heart out with things I've been through the past few years. So I'm very excited about it.
We all enjoy Boy Like Me. Good stuff.
You
got some up-and-coming guitar picker on that as well.
Yeah, Keith Urban. You might have heard of him.
Name.
Yeah, he's going to be, I think he's going to do well.
Not much doubt about that. We spoke to him earlier, and you run with some pretty powerful people in this town that have a lot of respect for your work.
Well, I have a lot of respect for them, and I'm very humbled that someone like Keith Urban
without harmonizing with somebody all the time?
It wasn't first, but the way we did the record, Jerry Flowers, my producer, who's been with Keith forever, he was in the ranch, he's still Keith's bass player. Jerry and I wrote a lot of this record together, and our voices blend really well. And that's something I hadn't done in a while, is having male harmony. So we sort of made it a point with this record to make it all male harmony, really no female harmony. It got sort of a different sound out of this record than the records album. And it's pretty cool. It's something different.
Yeah, we're happy for you. Good work.
Thank you.
Good work.
Thank you.
Pleasure to see you again.
You too.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Jessica Harp with us here live in Nashville on B93. Do you get tired of this? Are you exhausted yet?
It only happens a few times a year, so.
I'm
not exhausted yet. I got up at 3:30, so there will be a point in the day where I'll become exhausted, but that's why I keep drinking coffee.
Good job. Fun interview. Thank you.
Good to see you all.
Thanks, Jessica.